before you're all set to go on the air, you two miniature thespians, you. You both so cute. Look at y'all. You're so cute. Come on. They got the cutest little butts. I wonder how big...
Dion.
You know, Blair, I simply cannot believe we are here. We are official Saturday Night Live hairdressers. Look out, world. Here I come. I am at the apex of my hairstyling powers.
But what am I, the quiche time forgot?
Well, don't be silly, Blair. You're my precious assistant. Saturday Night Live today. Woo! Look at us. We're on Saturday Night Live. Maybe they'll discover me on the show. I can be on the show. I can say, I'm Dion Dion and you're not. Think of all the stars we're gonna meet.
Oh, well, that's nothing. Look at this. Take a gander. Who's hosting tonight's show? Mr. Newman.
Paul Newman? Ah! I love him. I even use his salad dressing for it. It has a uniquely piquant tang. And now I'm gonna do his hair on national television. Oh, sweet Jesus, I walk into the Valley of the Lord, and I walk out with Butch Cassidy.
Listen, Sundance, plug in your hairdryer. It's gonna be a busy night.
Fellas, this is Mr. Newman. He has to be ready in 5 minutes.
My God, what happened to you since the verdict?
I'd say it was definitely not in his favor. Poor Joanne Woodward. No wonder she took up needlepoint.
Gentlemen, you've been misinformed. I'm Edwin Newman, the newsman. I'm not Paul Newman, the actor, although I do enjoy his salad dressing, which has an unusually piquant tang.
Edwin Newman, of course. I knew it all along. Dion, you ignoramus, don't you ever watch the news?
I don't watch the news, Blair. I read it every week in the National Enquirer. Along with my horoscopes and some special features on potatoes shaped like Charlene Tilton. It's true.
Well, that's very nice.
Mr. Newman, it must be so exciting in the world of reportage, but like Vietnam and Beirut, but tell me something. Why don't you ever report on nice, fun places like San Francisco or Fire Island?
Because there's nothing happening there.
That's what you think, girlfriend. I guess you've never been there during spring vacation.
Well, I'll make a point of it next time.
You know something else I want to ask you? All you news people must be a very, very toasted, tight-knit group. Do you know Geraldo Rivera? Because I simply love him. He looked just like Tony Orlando. He could tie a yellow ribbon around my oak tree any time.
Come at it square, Mr. Newman.
Oh, Dion, we better get moving. The show must go on.
Oh, don't rush me. I'm an artiste, girl. Now, let me see. Let me see what I'm gonna do with him. It looks like this lamb needs a little bit more wool. Blair, give me the number three wig.
Coming right up.
Put that on you. Then, now you look just like that gentleman on Nightline.
Ted Koppel and I are very different types of newsmen. I respect him, but I don't want to look like him.
Well, I don't blame you. His hair looks like a remnant from a carpet warehouse anyway.
Oh, well, don't you get it, Dion? He'd rather be rather.
He is so fine, Dan Rather.
Well, let's give Edwin a nice sweater, a salt and pepper wig, and we'll just call it a day. There it is.
Well, the fact is, Dan is more aggressively sincere than I am. All I really need is a little pancake.
Well, what are you, a newsman or Aunt Jemima? You do the news and we'll do the hair. Put this back over here.
Just get me ready. We're running out of time.
Well, don't get tested with me. All right, listen, what I'm gonna do is, this is a very glamorous show. I'm gonna put your hair down here and we're gonna make you look like Walter Cronkite, but with Betty Davis eyes.
El Rongo, Dion, he should have a John Chancellor quality, but with an Ed McMahon zest for life.
Blair, you ignorant slut.
Come on, fellas, if you don't mind my calling you that.
You're on, Mr. Newman.
I'm not ready.
But we are...
Live from New York!